Nikki, President Donald Trump's impeachment trial has ended, and he gets to keep his job at the White House. And those who rejected the U.S. Senate's vote to acquit Trump took to the streets to protest what they call a sham trial.
Dozens of protesters gathered at the U.S. Capitol to reject the U.S. Senate's party-line vote to acquit President Donald Trump of abuse of power and obstruction of Congress.
We are here on a historic day, a very dark day in the history of this country. Everybody knows, the whole world has seen that Donald Trump is guilty.
It is a cover-up!
Acquittal is a cover-up!
It's shameful. The emperor has no clothes. The GOP senators aren't fooling the American people.
This protester, who came all the way from the San Francisco Bay Area, said the Senate failed to hold the president accountable.
I consider those people traitors to America.
It means we failed as a democracy and as a nation.
Fire! Retire!
To hold Trump accountable, these protesters urged the people to make their votes count on November 3rd.
Vote with our feet on the streets. Every day is November 3rd.
I believe Trump's acquittal can go both ways. It could either boost his re-election bid, or it could cost him the presidency as more revelations come up about his questionable actions in his first term in office. Nikki.
All right, Don, how are these protesters pushing for people to really make their votes count?
So now they're back to the drawing board, and their plan is to regroup, organize, and mobilize bigger and more widespread protests to show their outrage over Republicans for their, you know, for not doing the right thing and for turning a blind eye to a president who they said abused his powers and obstructed Congress, you know, to keep the story alive until November. Nikki.
Thanks for joining us live from Washington, D.C., Don Tagala.